Okay, thank you for the introduction. I'll be talking about the possibility of using MRI for the drug delivery. As we all know, of ultrasound-mediated drug delivery is becoming an alternative approach for brain-related disease treatment. And MRI is a promising tool, imaging tool for planning, evaluating, and then monitoring the treatment. But if we think of the alternative approach for drug delivery therapy into the brain, it is very important to know how much drug is going to deliver into the disease site before we start the procedure. So, so that previously we tried to calculate MR contrast agent as a surrogate tracer to predict how much drug is delivered during the therapy. But so the study was done in tumor, where tumor was increased, tumor was at different stages. So we could see that this is the ketones, so the permeability transfer coefficient of the MR contrast agent from blood to the brain parenchyma by calculating by the dynamic contrast enhanced imaging. So if we look at the ketones value on early stage tumor, it has an increasement by ultrasound, but not on the later stage tumor. But at the same time, if we look at the drug concentration on those tumors, as tumor grows bigger, the ultrasound is very effective to deliver the bigger size chemotherapeutics into the disease case. So that means there could be a trouble to predict or to surrogate MR contrast agent as a surrogate tracer to calculate the drug concentration in the disease site. So we suspect one thing that there could be a size mismatch between MRI contrast agent and the chemotherapy, which is about like 2 nanometers in the gadolinium is about 2 nanometers, and then lipodox is about 100 nanometer. So then the central idea was come up with, why don't we make a single particle that has imaging agent and the therapeutic agent in it, and to deliver through the ultrasound to pick those subtle changes if there is any. So to reach that the central goal, we were started the first step to look at or to make a liposomes which is labeled with gadolinium and is fluorescently labeled liposomes and delivered through the through the blood-brain barrier. So the main objectives are to make 2 different size liposomes, which are labeled with gadolinium and fluorescent, and then delivered through the blood-brain barrier using ultrasound, and look at the extravasation of that lipids, and then and also the measure the acoustic emission during the treatment procedure, whether they are size dependent or not. So since this is a collaborative work with Tyrone Porter's lab at Boston University, so the 2 different size particles were prepared over there, and they have 2 different groups. So the other one is almost a double size than the first group. And these are the sonication parameters that that's typically we use for the BBB opening. And we listen the passive cap, I mean, we listen the microbubble activities during the sonication, whether there could be some behavior on, I mean, dependent on size or not. And for fluorescent measurement, we sack the animal in 24 hours after the sonication and then post-process. So we started to detect gadolinium leakage 5 hours after the sonication, but these analyses are from 24 hours after the sonication. So if we look at the T1 contrast enhanced imaging, we could see the gadolinium leakage on sonicated location, but not other side of the brain. And if we calculate the signal intensity enhancement on sonicated location compared with the non-sonicated controls, we could see that the gadolinium enhancement is increased by 26%, which is statistically significant compared with the control side. So in group two, if we calculate the signal intensity, it is only increased by 24%, which is not significant as compared with the control. And if we compare two groups, then the signal intensity was not significant, the difference between two groups. But we experienced there is a higher concentration with the smaller size particles. Since liposomes is fluorescently labeled, we measure the lipid concentration by measuring the signal intensity of that fluorescence in bulk tissue. So this is the concentration of the lipids in the control versus sonicated tissue. We could see that there is an increasement by 62% on sonicated cases versus control, which is significantly enhanced. But in bigger size liposomes, there is a 40% increase, but it is not significantly, it is not statistically significant. So same thing, when we compare two different groups, it is barely, it is on the borderline somehow, but it is not significant, but we experience higher concentration of lipids on sonicated tissue when it was a smaller size. So we could conclude that ultrasound can be used to deliver such bigger liposomes up to 150 nanometer size with ultrasound. And even though they are not significantly different between two groups, but we experience there is a higher concentration. Smaller liposomes can leak easier than the other one, but we did not experience acoustic activities difference between two groups. So the next step would be to if there is a way to work on it, we could potentially bring therapeutics in the combination or the other way around to deliver through the barrier and pick use the dynamic contrast imaging to get those information from the blood-brain barrier integrity. So I would like to thanks to the funding body and our FUS family at Boston. And thank you for your attention. I am happy to have questions. Thank you.
Time for one question. Well, I have a question. Do you think those liposomes stay intact when they go through the blood-brain barrier, or do you have to? Do you think that the liposomes stay intact when you sonicate them? Are you sonicating them at the same time that the bubbles are there?
Actually, this is the liposomes was injected before sonication. So, the liposomes are already in the system. And previously, what we were experiencing is if the bigger size molecules is already in the system, and then we start sonicate, we were getting higher concentration compared to the others. So this is the idea why we inject the liposomes earlier.
Yeah, Jana, I agree with that. Do you think that they stay intact? You don't think that the cavitation activity will break the liposomes in the circulation?
In one aspect, I could say they are intact. It delivered, everything delivered. Because there was no leakiness of the gadolinium right after the sonication. So we were detecting 5 hours after the sonication. The gadolinium leakage was 5 hours after.
Okay.
So that there could be a delivery of entire package.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.